Good morning, guys. I have just woken up. The sun is shining right onto my face, which makes me so happy. So for today's vlog, I thought I'd do something a little bit different to what I normally do. I'm always getting so many questions on how I take my photos when I do it street style, how I get ready for them, all of that sort of thing. So I thought that today I would take you guys along with me to my shoot, show you guys how I get ready for it, give you guys some tips and tricks, and yeah, I thought that would be really fun. So it is 7 o'clock. In the winter, the light goes at around, say, like 2:45. Obviously the sun sets about 4:30, but from any time from about 2:45, I just don't like shooting. The light goes really blue, doesn't look good. So I always aim to shoot earlier, just so I'm not rushed. And the light is just so much better as well. And I think the key to good photos is good lighting. I'm also gonna be showing you guys the jewelry I wear today. This video is actually in collaboration with Mejuri, which is one of my favorite jewelry brands. I'm always wearing their stuff. I'm always getting so many questions on every single video that I do. So I'm very proud to be working with them. I can't wait to show you guys everything that I wear from them, but I'll do that later when I'm getting ready. Anyway, I'm gonna jump into the shower, so I'll see you guys in a bit. Here is my delicious Sunday breakfast. Got a poached egg on avocado toast and a smoothie. Also always add paprika to my avo. It's just the nicest thing ever. B just made me a cup of tea. This is the Tea's white tea and raspberry rose. It's the best. And I'm now sat at the dining table. I'm gonna do my makeup with you guys. I don't normally do my makeup at the dining table, but the light here is a lot better than in my bedroom right now. So let's go. Hair is up. Ignore my slightly dirty dressing gown. I always do my makeup in the dressing gown, so it gets a bit dirty. Is my makeup done? I'm now going to quickly run downstairs, pick up a parcel for something I want to shoot today. So this is what was in the parcel, which makes my first outfit really easy because it's already done and chosen. Got this gorgeous teddy coat, which I'm just obsessed with. Nice plain grey hoodie and some new white trainers. I love the chunky sole on these. I'll link all of this down below. So something that's really important for me and my shoots is, of course, the styling and accessorizing. I honestly believe that the smallest details in photos just makes it look so much better, and I personally just feel really naked when I don't wear jewelry. Jewelry is something that I really love and I'm very passionate about, but I'm also very fussy with it. It has to be really good quality, it has to be authentic, and most importantly, it has to last, because I'm the kind of person who likes to wear jewelry in the shower, in bed. I don't really like taking my jewelry off. And for me, Mejuri are just the perfect jewelry brand because, first of all, their pieces are stunning. They've got a really good range of jewelry. It's also super affordable compared to a lot of other brands. On the website, it actually has a feature where it says the Mejuri price and then what it would be normally at retail. And I just think they are a great brand to get into luxury, fine jewelry, but without the huge price tag. And of course, it is Black Friday week this week, which means they have a sale on, and their sale is really good. So what they're doing is you get get 10% off if you buy one item, 15% off if you buy two, and 20% off if you buy three items, which I think is a great deal. Perfect if you want to treat yourself, or just send over all the links to any family members or boyfriends or girlfriends that you want to be treated by this Christmas. So one of the first pieces I ever picked up from Mejuri is this diamond necklace here. And I normally wear this 24/7, but I did take it off last night because I fake tanned, and I just don't like the idea of getting fake tan all over this. So this is actually a real diamond. Their diamonds are ethically sourced, and full price, this is $295, which is so affordable for diamonds. This was actually my first ever piece of diamond jewelry, which is such a big deal for me. I'm just gonna put it on so you can see how it looks. It has three different hoops so you can adjust it, but I like to wear it just about here, and I just think it is so elegant and so minimal. So yeah, this normally doesn't come off my neck, and I always get so many questions about this when I wear it in videos. They also have a large one, which I think is $950. The diamond is just a lot bigger. And then a new addition to my Mejuri collection is this. This is their crescent necklace, and the gems you can see here are sapphire. They look a lot like diamonds, but they don't have the diamond price tag, so this necklace is only £65. And then with this one, I just think it looks really pretty layered up with the diamond necklace. So there, as you can see, they just look really nice layered up together, and because they are so dainty and minimal, they just work perfectly. And even though this one is sapphire and this one is diamond, they look exactly the same. Another new addition to my Mejuri collection is this bracelet here. This is their bold link chain bracelet. Again, this is an 18 karat gold vermeil bracelet. Absolutely just love how dainty it is. It's also got a really modern feel with kind of like the rectangular chains. I just think this is a really nice basic piece of jewelry. Oh my god, this sun is really coming through now, which is a good thing because it just goes to show how well these catch the light. And even though they're so small, they do really kind of pop. Okay, and then finally onto my rings. We're going to have to allow the lockdown nails. I'll start off with the ones I've had for a long time. So these two top ones here I've had for a few months now. So I've actually stacked these as a three. These don't come off my hands. I actually don't know if I can get them off my hands. But yeah, these are three separate rings, as you can see. This top one here is their solo diamond ring. Okay, this sunshine is insanely bright. I'm gonna move quickly. There we go, that's much better. So again, it's a really simple design, and I just think it makes a really nice stacking ring. So I've stacked it with the diamonds team ring, which has diamonds all along the front half, and then it's just a plain gold band at the back. They have three different versions of these. So there's one of like a quarter full of diamonds, there's one with half like this one, and then there's one with all the way diamonds along the middle, and then obviously they just have the varying price points. The one I have is £380, which for a ring of this many diamonds, I just think is such good value for money. And yeah, honestly, they're just so sparkly. They just always catch my attention. So obsessed with them. And then this one here right at the bottom is their bold stacker ring, which is just your box standard basic gold band ring. And I just thought it was really perfect for stacking. Yeah, and I just mainly wanted just to add it on to this little trio. Before it was a little double, and now it's a trio. And I just like the height it gives them. And then moving on to this hand, these two here are new additions. We have the duo ring, which is two. Actually, I can get this one off quite easily. It's two rings attached, as you can see. One of them is like a spiraled kind of design, and then the other one is just a plain. And then this one here is their solo diamond baguette ring. So it's that rectangular shape on a really thin band, which I just love. My hands are tiny and my fingers are quite short, so I find that I kind of have to go for quite dainty, slim rings. Otherwise, it just doesn't really work for me. And again, it's a real diamond. It's in this beautiful rectangular shape. And this would work, again, really well with stacking. So as I build up my collection, I'm probably going to stack some maybe like plain bands around it, maybe another like diamond one all the way around. I think that would look really lovely. What I really like is that I can actually just mix and match all of these rings up together on their own. So yeah, that is my whole Mejuri jewelry collection. Such a huge fan of the brand. I think 80% of their employees are women as well, which makes me very happy. And I just love the concept of making fine jewelry more accessible and more affordable to people. So I will be linking everything down below, of course. And remember, if you get one thing, it's 10%, two things, 15% off, and three things, 20% off. Anyway, the sun is shining. It is now 10 o'clock, so I kind of want to leave in the next like half an hour or so to go take my pics. So I've obviously got my first outfit, and I'm going to do two today because it just makes it more worth your while when you go out and you shoot two outfits rather than one. So for the second outfit, what I do is I'll look at my feed
and try and think, like, what sort of thing do I want to add to it? What have I not done in a while? What have I done recently? So looking at my feed now, I'm like, okay, I've done a blazer recently, aviator jacket. I haven't really done any like fur coats recently, obviously faux fur, not real fur. And I also think, what bags have I not used recently? And by the looks of things, I haven't used my Louis Vuitton bag in a while, so I might add that in. And yeah, this way you're kind of keeping things fresh, you're not repeating yourself, and you're keeping things new. I will then go into my wardrobe and have a look at things, piece things together. I normally have like one main focus. So for example, it might be a coat, and then I'll work the outfit around the coat. Or if I'm like, oh, I haven't shopped mum jeans in a while, which I haven't actually. The last time I shopped mum jeans is down here, and I've worked on all of these since. So then I'll focus the outfit around the mum jeans. So it's good to have one thing and then plan the outfit around it, rather than having all of these ideas and not sort of knowing what to do, because then that gets overwhelming. Another thing I do as well is have a little scroll on Pinterest to see what I've pinned recently, and that will often give me loads of outfit ideas. I'll leave my Pinterest down below again. But yeah, this is a really, oh, it's me, hello me. But yeah, this is just the best way of getting inspo. I will also look at Pinterest for like poses and stuff. So for example, like this is quite a cool look. I really like the way she's kind of got her hand over her face, she's walking towards camera. I think that's a really cool shot. And then there's things like this, so kind of one leg up, half sitting. That looks really cool. So just kind of grabbing inspiration so you can figure out what you want to do. So this coat is a new addition to my coat collection. It's just gorgeous. I'll link this down below. But yeah, I really want to shoot this. So this will be like my main focus, and then I'll plan the outfit around it. This is my like underneath outfit today. I've got this plain black jersey top on and leather leggings. And I always have like a base outfit on when I shoot, because one, it makes changing really easy. It means you don't have to like strip off to change outfits. I can just put a jumper over the top of this, or I can put a hoodie over the top of this. And then with these leggings as well, I often will wear like black leggings underneath this. So if I want to change my trousers, I can easily take my trousers off without, again, getting naked in public. So I always go for something really plain and simple underneath, so I can just get changed over the top of it. And it's also the kind of outfit where if you just change the top half and then your shoes and then the coat, maybe change the bag, you have a completely different outfit, but with this all underneath, it makes it super easy. So my next tip is to try on the outfits you're gonna shoot. Don't put them together in your head, because often I'll put something together in my head and in real life, it just doesn't work. For example, this outfit, I thought this would be really cute with this like faux fur coat, mum jeans and these boots, but it actually just doesn't work. It looks a bit mix and matchy. So I'm going to either change the trousers or change the coat. Okay, so I changed the coat and look how much better this is. Just works so much more cohesively. Only thing though, it means I'm choosing two black coats today, which I don't really want to do. I can always separate the content out quite a bit, I guess. And then I just try on different shoes, see which one works best. I think for this outfit, white works best. So before we shoot, I normally have like an idea of roughly where I want to shoot. It's good to have like an idea of the kind of vibe you want. Like, do you want like a modern vibe, like classic kind of houses vibe, plain concrete? So I always kind of work that in my head beforehand. Otherwise, we will just drive around forever and we won't be able to choose a place. We're on a very pretty street right now, and we're going to shoot the first outfit. And B's going to take a pic as well. This is our current view. The light's looking a little bit blue, which isn't fab. And it's all looking kind of a bit shady, but we'll work out. And then what I do first is I use B as my little light test. Test the light this way, doesn't look great. So I then ask her to switch round, do it the opposite direction. The light is so much better this way, so we're gonna shoot this direction.
Wait, you're right like by that thing.
Let's see.
Yeah, this is much better.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Only thing is that pole is a bit annoying.
Oh, I don't mind the pole. I think maybe the angle needs to be different. Like, not as straight on. I'm a little bit, yeah. The lighting isn't as good here at all.
Really?
No, go back. I didn't take the picture, but yeah. It looks shit.
That's really annoying. I just think there's too much stuff going on in the background of the pole.
Well, go back and I'll try and get the pole out.
So, as you can see, we kind of just move around trying out the light, different locations. It's annoying because even if I love a location, I won't shoot there because the light's bad. The light, like I said earlier, just makes such a difference. So I ended up shooting just here, which isn't very autumnal or very interesting. It's just a white wall, but the light here was banging. So now I'm just taking some pics of B. So now we go back into the car, get out the second outfit. I'm gonna normally just change to the back of my car because it's more room. So I'm just going to put on these jeans. I've got leggings underneath these leggings, so obviously it's easy to get changed. And even if someone does see me, it's all good. I've protected my modesty. I'm getting changed. Oh my god, these leggings look really dirty. Oh, it's just fluff. Got ourselves pret. I went for a gingerbread latte, but you got an oat milk hot chocolate. Also got some bits for lunch. Now we're just on the route to find a second place to shoot. So you guys are always asking me as well how I don't find it embarrassing taking photos in public. And the way I see it is that you're probably not going to see these people again. And if they do decide to judge you, then that's kind of their issue, not really yours. Like, you're actually quite weird if you're judging somebody for taking photos in public. Like, it's 2020, so it's... like I said, it's their issue, not yours. But I used to get really embarrassed, but then I switched my mindset and now I think like that. Another thing as well is I noticed that when I was shooting for brands, so if I was like modeling for the day for a brand, not for myself, I wasn't embarrassed because I knew that I was doing a job for them and it was my job, that's what I had to do. So sometimes when I do feel a bit self-conscious, I kind of just pretend that I'm doing it for somebody else, and for some reason that helps. Yeah, it's just something you've got to get used to. I really don't care. Obviously we just started taking pictures of B-lots as well, and you were really embarrassed at first, weren't you?
Yeah,
but you've got really good at it now, like you don't really care so much, do you?
No.
And you've only done it like a few times, so...
Yeah, but I think if you find like a quiet place and you're comfortable,
yeah,
you're wearing or whatever.
Yeah, that's another thing as well, like to build up your confidence, maybe start by going somewhere really quiet, like where we are now is pretty quiet. Like maybe avoid weekends, so yeah,
and
there's
have,
people.
Like, a supportive person taking your photos.
Yeah,
that's really important.
Yeah, definitely. If you take a photo of the person taking a photo of you, and do the exact angle, the exact frame, everything like that, it makes it a lot easier for the person taking a photo of you to take it because they know what they want, and then that way you're going to be happier with the photo, and it's going to be easier for the person taking the photo as well. So on my phone I've got about a million photos of B where I've been like, this is what I want, this is what, like, the location I want, this is the angle, and it just makes everyone's life a bit easier. Alright, so look at this house, how insane is that? Oh my god! It's amazing. B made another good point just there, and she said, when the person taking photos of you is really encouraging, it gives you more confidence, so like, when I take photos of B, if I like something, I'll be like, yeah, yeah, do that pose, or, oh, that doesn't look so good, maybe try this. Giving a bit of direction and then also giving encouragement as well really helps. So make sure you're with somebody who is like that. Anyway, we've just been going around and having a little walk really because the light is rather weird at the moment. So you, look, as you can see, either in direct sunlight or it's kind of quite blue toned because I don't know why it's blue toned today, it's just the sky. I haven't managed to take a second photo yet, but we'll try. Here, I'm now going to take B's photos. We've got a bit of a back light, which is just beautiful. I think that's very flattering, but the only thing is it means there's a bit of a glare, as you can see on camera.
Do you think I should do on one side?
Yeah, I think one side. Wait, can you quickly clean your camera for me? I would clean it, but my hands are like full. That's another tip, guys, always clean your camera, makes the quality so much better.
Hair? Is it really flat?
Yeah, no, that's nice, that's nice, leave it like that. Yeah, these are nice, the light's so good. Love these, very cute. And then I always get B to take a look, like we'll do maybe 10 photos and B can have a look, see if she likes them, and then that saves you taking like 100 photos and then to decide that you don't like the background. So it's good just to get like a few test shots in.
I like these.
You like them?
Can we just take a couple more?
Yeah, of course. Oh,
these are really cute.
Can do more. We've definitely got one there.
So we had a successful shoot in the end. Both got two photos. Another tip I just thought of now is to kind of get the most out of your content is to take a full length body shot of your outfit and then a close one as well. That way you're getting two photos in one shot, not one shot, in one shoot. And then what I normally do is I'll just spread it out on my feed so it's not like repetitive.
We should do a video where we have like questions in the car and we answer them.
Okay.
So like somebody will be like,
what you mean you ask your followers?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, okay.
Like dilemmas or just general life questions.
We should go on a cycles. I really like that.
Yeah, we should do that.
Yeah. Should we do that?
Let's do it. We could do it somewhere really nice like Regent's Park. Hyde Park. No, not Hyde Park. Yeah, Hyde Park. Let's do Hyde Park.
Yeah.
We can go around the lake.
Yeah. Let's definitely do that.
Oh, what about coronavirus though? Like, we'd have to, I guess, we could sanitise the bikes really well.
Obviously. Get a wipe.
Yeah.
You want me to do it? I'll show you more.
Did you just hear what I said?
No.
My sugar plum.
My sugar plum.
That's definitely not the word.
Bea's the queen of making up words and she doesn't know what they are.
Whoa!
Jesus!
Oh my god!
See, I have a death wish. The guy literally just tried to run into my car.
Your phone's right there.
Guys, I was just looking for my phone. Buddy right here. My camera battery died, which is why I've been filming on my phone, by the way. I just love the sun so much. It gives me such good vibes.
Me too.
Makes me so happy.
Same. It's the winter sun though that makes me the happiest.
Yeah, winter sun is so much better than summer sun.
I absolutely hate summer sun.
Yeah, it's too sticky. Winter sun is so clear and crisp.
It's just enjoyable.
It's just beautiful.
Summer sun makes you want to be sick.
Oh god.
Getting way too hot.
So many sausage dogs.
There are, aren't there?
Spare
yeah.
How many do you think we've seen today? I reckon at least 20.
I was going to say 25.
Yeah, probably around 25. What should we have for dinner?
Ooh, something Sunday-y. Not a roast though, we already had a roast this week.
We do have leftover though. I love how we always copy each other. Like, you're putting on lip gloss, I put on lip gloss. You put on, I put on sunglasses and then you straight away put your sunglasses on.
I love this lip gloss. Wow! Hey, do we want to stop at the bank?
Oh, where is it?
Just over there, I think.
Is it? Oh, it's there, down. Isn't it? I actually cannot see.
No, it's not here.
There it is.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
We're just going to stop off at the clothes bank to give some clothes to charity.
Two ginormous, actually, no. One ginormous and one small cauliflower.
Yeah.
So thinking I could make cauliflower based pizzas.
Oh, I've never heard of that before.
What?
Is that a thing?
Yeah.
Cauliflower based pizzas?
Yeah. That's a massive thing.
You're making that sound really normal.
It is normal.
I've never heard of cauliflower based pizzas.
Well, you've obviously had your head stuck somewhere. Oh, honestly, that like takes something out of me.
By the way guys, I'm not speeding, don't worry. I don't go with the speed limit.
We are now home. I'm just having my pret soup. I just warmed it up in the microwave with this bread roll from Pret as well. These rolls are so good. Oh, look at that bread, stunning. Okay, so I'm just gonna get on with some work now. I've got a really busy week ahead, so I wanna be ahead of things and organized. I'm gonna do a little bit of editing right now. Good evening guys, it's now quite a bit later.
and I've just been sat editing and working and just doing bits ready for the week ahead. I'm about to make dinner, gonna make just like leftovers. I've got loads of leftovers in the fridge. So I'm going to end this vlog here. I have got a few more videos coming out this week, which is very exciting. I really hope you enjoyed this vlog. I hope it was insightful and interesting to see how I shoot. And again, a massive shout out and a massive thank you to Mejuri for sponsoring this video. I will see you all in my next video. I love you all so, so, so much. Bye.